Yes, everyone. Welcome back on my YouTube channel. Welcome back on Physics Corner. Today, I have one question that I want to try to solve this question. Please take a look what this question is. Okay. Or I read it first about this question. A uniform plane of width 120 newton rests on two stools, as shown in figure 5.16. This is the plane one. So let's say this is plane. I may sit on this plane. A weight of 80 newton is placed on the plane midway between the stools. Calculate the force acting on the stool at A. The force acting on the stool at B also. Okay, this is midway of two tools. Not midway at the plane. So the length of the plank is 4 meter and here is 80. This is 80 newton. And let's say this is point A. So we can say this is force A and here is force B. Let's say this is B point. So FA and FB, we need to find this. Yes. For to find force A, we need to rotate this plane. Use the torque. At the point B equals to zero. For to find force A, and total torque on A is zero to find the force on B. So we can continue here. If we use the first one, total torque at point B equal to zero. So we can use this is actually like all the force is rotated by the pivot of B. So we can say this is force A, positive force A times distance between point at the force A to point B. So let's say we know this is 4 meter, this is a half meter and this is 1 meter. So here to here, point A to B equals to 4 minus 1, 3, 3 minus 0.5, 2.5, this is 2.5 meter. Let's say I use the bracket 1, this is about distance between force A to point B, Now, also about, we have a plane width, 120 newton. If we say this is one and this is a half, so midway. Near with 80 newton, but on the right side, let's say here, this is 120 newton. Weight of the plank, and here 80 newton is the block. So we have also about 8 newton. This is minus. Why minus? Because the rotation of the force depends on the B point is anti-clockwise. Also 120 also anti-clockwise, negative also. So we can say here is negative of 80 newton times, yes, distance between this block and here, because this block is midway of point A and B. So point A and B is distance is 2.5, 2.5. So we can say here is 1.2525 meters, because divided by 2, a half of distance between A to B. And negative 120, the distance between 120 newtons to B point. Okay, actually this is a midpoint of plane. So here equals to 2 meters. We already know this is 1 meter, so we can say the point between 120 newton to point B equals to 1. Yes, here is 1 equals to 0. We have one equation, and finally we can find the FA. FA times 2.5. I will use the calculator to find the number. It says about 80 times with 1.25 equals to 100. Actually this is 100 and plus plus 120 newton, so we can get here as 220. So F in A equals to 220 divided by 2.5. We can get the 88 newton. Yes, done for the question A. The force acting on the stones at A, on the stone A. Actually, this is normal contact on the pivot A. Now go directly to the point, to the find the force on B point. So the opposite of the way the one. We need calculate this calculation by total torque in point A equals to 0. Use this equation to find the force on the point A and point B. So the next, this is the calculation here will be opposite of the way one. So total torque at A, we can start from FB. FB, if we rotate with point A, this is become the anti-clockwise. So we can say here is negative FB. FB times distance between point B to point A, it's equals to 4 minus 1.5. This is 2.5. 2.5 meters. 4 minus 1 minus a half, so equals to 2.5. And the block one, the block one is positive, because after we rotate with point A, this is on the clockwise, and the distance here, because block is midway of point A and B, this is a half of 2.5. You can say here 80 times 1.25 meter. Then plus again with 120, 120. So distance between 120 newton to B equals to but 1. So how about this to this? Because this is 2.5. 2.5. Here is 1. So here is 1.5. Yes, correct. 1.5 meter. Then equals to
0.
Yeah, continue again. Yeah, so we can say here again 80. Yeah, 80 times 1.25. Actually, same thing with this one. This is about 100. Yeah, 100 plus. FB times 2.5 as the 280 newton. So FB equals to 280 newton divided by 2.5. Yes, 112. Okay, finally we get the FA and FB. That's normal contact force on the pivot A and the pivot B. Yes. So I just prove it, this number. Yeah. So we can say if we calculate here, if we sum FA plus FB as the FA plus FB, let me see, this is about 88, yeah, plus 112, yeah, 112. So we can see here how much is it. Yes, 200 newton. Yeah. To prove this question, is it correct or no, we can say here 200 newton, it's same with the force on the going down. So yeah, this is 200 newton, same thing with this one, right? 80 plus 120 equals to, yes, 200 newton. Yeah, this is and the equilibrium. So we can say, or we come back to Newton's first law, that's total force equals to zero. Yes, correct. So this is the correct answer, because on the different set we can say this is same thing. Yeah. Okay, I think enough. Thank you very much for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like, comment, also share to the other. Thank you very much, and see you in other videos.